Imagine a vibrant city with a well-functioning infrastructure, represented by a healthy liver. The liver performs essential functions in the body such as detoxification, metabolism, and production of important proteins. Just like the city's administration and infrastructure, it is a vital organ that keeps everything running smoothly. Now consider the effects of cirrhosis. Just like the extensive damage and decay of a city, the liver can be affected by various factors such as chronic alcohol use, hepatitis infections, or certain diseases. These factors progressively damage liver cells, leading to inflammation and scarring. Liver disease can be caused by a variety of causes, can lead to chronic inflammation or cholestasis, and can ultimately result in cirrhosis. Identifying the underlying cause of cirrhosis is very important as it influences treatment decisions, allows counseling of family members, and helps to predict the patient's prognosis. The initial evaluation includes taking a detailed medical history, performing a thorough physical examination and routine blood tests, including liver biochemical and function tests, as well as a complete blood count. The findings from this initial assessment serve as a guide for further diagnostic testing. The clinical manifestations of cirrhosis encompass a range of symptoms and signs that can manifest in various ways. Initially, individuals may experience nonspecific symptoms such as loss of appetite, weight loss, general weakness, and constant fatigue. As the condition progresses, hepatic decompensation can occur, leading to more obvious indicators such as jaundice, yellowing of the skin and eyes, intense itching of the skin, pruritus, visible signs of upper gastrointestinal bleeding, abdominal distension caused by fluid accumulation, ascites, and cognitive confusion resulting from hepatic encephalopathy. Healthcare professionals may observe additional physical signs of cirrhosis during a physical examination. These include jaundice, the appearance of spider-like blood vessels, spider angioma, abnormal breast enlargement in men, gynecomastia, fluid in the abdominal cavity, ascites, enlarged spleen, splenomegaly, redness of the palms, palmar erythema, clubbing of the fingertips, digital clubbing, and involuntary clapping, asterixis. In addition to observable clinical signs, laboratory tests play a crucial role in the diagnosis of cirrhosis. The results of these tests usually reveal elevated serum bilirubin levels, abnormal aminotransferase, liver enzymes, values, increased alkaline phosphatase and gamma-glutamyl transpeptidase, markers of liver function, prolonged prothrombin time or high international normalized ratio, INR, indicating impaired blood clotting, low sodium levels in the blood, hyponatremia, and decreased platelet count, thrombocytopenia. These laboratory abnormalities help confirm the diagnosis and assess the severity of cirrhosis. In patients suspected of having cirrhosis, abdominal imaging, typically with ultrasound, is performed to evaluate the liver parenchyma and to identify any extrahepatic manifestations of cirrhosis. Although a liver biopsy is necessary for definitive diagnosis, it may not be necessary if clinical, laboratory, and radiologic data strongly support the presence of cirrhosis, and obtaining biopsy results will not significantly affect the management of the patient. Furthermore, non-invasive serologic and radiographic approaches are being developed as alternative diagnostic methods for cirrhosis. Cirrhosis is usually suspected in patients with symptoms of chronic liver disease detected on physical examination. Evidence of cirrhosis in laboratory or radiological tests or by direct imaging during a surgical procedure. Evidence of decompensated cirrhosis characterized by the presence of dramatic and life-threatening complications such as variceal bleeding, ascites, spontaneous bacterial peritonitis or hepatic encephalopathy. The main complications of cirrhosis are variceal bleeding, acids, spontaneous bacterial peritonitis, hepatic encephalopathy, hepatocellular carcinoma, hepatorenal syndrome, hepatopulmonary syndrome. When these complications develop, patients are considered to have decompensated cirrhosis. Multiple factors can predispose to decompensation in a patient with cirrhosis. Risk factors for decompensation include bleeding, infection, alcohol intake, medications, dehydration, and constipation. In addition, patients with obesity are at higher risk for decompensation. When decompensation develops, patients should be considered for liver transplantation. Other important complications of cirrhosis include portal vein thrombosis and cardiomyopathy. However, patients with these complications alone are not considered to have decompensated cirrhosis. The main objectives of managing patients with cirrhosis are slowing or reversing the progression of liver disease, prevention of overlapping damage to the liver, identification of medicines that require dosage adjustment or should be avoided altogether, management of symptoms and laboratory abnormalities, prevention, identification, and treatment of complications of cirrhosis, determining eligibility and optimal timing for liver transplantation. The prognosis of cirrhosis can vary significantly due to multiple factors, including its underlying cause, severity, the presence of complications, and coexisting medical conditions. If decompensation sets in, such as the development of variceal bleeding, hepatic encephalopathy, or spontaneous bacterial peritonitis, the likelihood of mortality increases.